What's up, everybody? It is I, Carlton Flowers, your crypto pro.
Yay!
And tonight I wanted to squeeze in a mobile report for a drop day preview on the Labbit collection, because this is going to be a monumental collection, in my opinion. If the series 1 and 2 were any indication, I think this set is going to be equally as valuable, with extreme growth possibilities, just like what we saw in the first and second sets. And we also have the great fun of trying to figure out which one of these is going to be the club banger, which one is going to jump out and have extreme value possibilities. Is it going to be the common, the uncommon, the rare, or the ultra rare? Just like we saw in the last set, we know that a common can come up and be the complete piece de resistance. You never know. In the last, we've had, what, two or three drops here in the last month where the common was the one that came away from the show with the highest market value. All right. So, with the numbers in this drop, and they're very, very, very low, okay? I mean, you're talking the common with 3,888, which is less in number than some of the ultra rares that we see in other sets, okay? And so this tells me that you've got very small chances of landing one on this drop. So don't be upset if you cannot land one of these right off the bat. In fact, don't be upset if it's very difficult to get these in the market, because we do not have a high number of these to go around. Now, with the rumor of Labbits being breedable, there's a lot of demand. There'll be a lot of attention placed on this drop. So just remember that as we look at the uncommon with an even lower count of 2,888, and it's only 30 gems. All right, moving on to the rare, and we're looking at 1,888. Very, very, very slim chances of getting that one. And then on the ultra rare, well, we've only got 888, and your chances of getting in the ultra rare on this drop are slim to none. And slim just left out the back door, okay? You get what I'm saying here? Now, you can decide for yourself, what are you going to go for? Are you going to try for the ultra rare with your smallest percent, your smallest probability, smallest chances of being able to land an item? Or are you going to increase your odds and go for the common? Now, based on the last few drops where I am seeing commons coming out with the highest valuation, the highest market value, I'm going to bet on the common. Okay, now number one, I like the artwork, and I like the fact that the common and the uncommon are almost exact opposites. All right, we've got the white rabbit with the green mustache, the green rabbit with the white mustache, and then the Christmas sweater. So either one of these could be really popular as far as aftermarket sales. All right, or post-drop sales. Demand, that's what I'm trying to think of, demand. So I will put my attention on the common, of course, because I have my greatest chances of landing one in the drop. I wouldn't mind having one of each of these, but I know that that's not a possibility for me, because once these get in the market, we're going to see ridiculous prices on that ultra rare, just like we have in the first two sets that came out. The rare would be nice to have, but I think this one, you're going to see this probably shoot up upwards of 200 to 300. And on your common and your uncommon, I wouldn't be surprised if we see 100 to 175. The ultra rare, all bets are off. We saw prices upwards of, what, 2,000 on the last drop with the ultra rare? And I think it even went higher than that in the months, or within the first few days after the drop. And then in the months afterward, it settled down and was as low as, what, 1,600 gems, somewhere around there? So the ultra rare is pretty much going to be out of reach, and I will not spend my hard earned money on that after the drop. But I will, like I said, focus on the common. Now, if I shoot craps and don't get anything, being fast on the buy button, then I may look at trying to time it out and pull off a common on the market. But I probably won't do that the first day because these things go just up and down, up and down. It's very, the price variation is so ridiculous, just like what we saw on the drop today. Oh my goodness, with the Mickey Mouse drop, the prices were hanging around 120 on the common and uncommon. They shot up as high as 600 when people were not able to flip the ones that they were buying on the market. And then we saw them settle back in the 200 to 300 range. Well, you might see the same thing here, but you can base the price action on this set on the last two and pretty much know what to expect. So on these, you have to hit the buy button, and if you do it early, you're going to get that error screen. And it used to be that you would align the buy button with the error button, and then you would just punch through like this. And they would call that, I can't remember if they call that spamming the buy button and hammering through the error button, the error screen. But here's the thing. It has come to the point now where if you hit this early, by the time you hit this okay and hit buy again, it's sold out. The only way that you're going to get this is if, let's say this is the countdown here, 24, 23, 22, 21, then you get the zero, then 1 second, and then boom. The only way you're going to get one is if you time this where you're hitting the buy button about 1/10 of a second after it opens up. And again, when it hits zero, that's not the time to hit the buy button. You have 1 full second after 3, 2, 1, 0, then you hit the buy button. And if you want to practice this and see what I'm talking about, download the VeVe Dropaholic app if you have an Android phone, and you will see for yourself, because you can practice each one of the drops, and you will see a countdown, and you'll see what happens when you hit the buy now button when it's first at zero. But if you wait 1 full second, you will be able to purchase the item. Well, possibly. You got to have good timing. It's just got to be so close after that full second that you're hitting it within 1/10 of a second that the buy button is available. So that's how you're going to use, that's your strategy for landing an item on this drop. Now, after this is all said and done, I'm thinking that the next drop, it might not cause a big gem squeeze. It's the stamp drop, which I will be doing a drop day preview on that set, because that's one of the most important ones that, based on what I've seen in the last year, this one has the most potential of basically any drop. And I'll tell you why in the next video. But at any rate, we will have more of a gem squeeze coming up from the drops that are scheduled further on out in the 12 days of whatever you want to call it. But tonight, we're seeing prices moving up, and tomorrow after this drop, we might see another rebound. So the opportunity to grab stuff super cheap is not quite what I thought it would be. I thought the gem squeeze would be a lot harder, and that pricing would have really been reduced much farther than what we are seeing right now. And I'd love to know your opinion about market prices during the gem squeeze season. Now, in the next video, I will tell you about what I've been scooping up in the background while everybody is clamoring over the drops. I have several stacking reports, and then I'm going to do a general video and show you some of these sets that have great items in them that you need to know about while everyone else is super focused on each new drop. All right, well, that's about all I have for now. I'll come back after the drop and let you know how I did, and I'd sure like to hear back from you. So like and subscribe if you haven't already, and shout out to all of my longtime followers who've been around since last March when I started this channel. Woo! I really appreciate all the positive and supportive comments. That makes it so much worth the while to put in all the work that it takes to crank these videos out. And last but not least, shout out to the Twitter crew, everybody out there on Twitter that I've been chopping it up with. It's been such a pleasure to interact and meet so many new people on Twitter. You all are the best. All right. Well, this is Carlton, and that's all I've got. I am out.